transpire. So a lot of you have many questions and you keep asking me what camera I use, what software I use and how to start a YouTube channel. So in this video, I'll be sharing with you guys my experience and everything that I know and that has helped me ever since I've started my own channel. I don't have that many subscribers to share successful tips on how to start a YouTube channel, but I started from scratch without tripod, without DSLR, so I do have a lot of things to share with you guys and I'm sure this video will be helpful. So without wasting time, let's get started. So the first thing is to create a channel. You can just go through tutorials that are on YouTube on how to start a YouTube channel. Also make sure to check out the settings of YouTube channel, how to create AdSense account and everything, because it is very important to know everything about monetization and everything before you start your own channel. So make sure to check out all the tutorials. I'll link one tutorial in the description box that I think might help you guys. And also which channel to create, which is very important. I love art. I love dance, I love DIY, a lot of things. So I was really confused on what type of channel I should start. You can go for beauty channel, comedy channel, DIY channel or an art channel, anything that you love. Second is a good channel name, which is very important and plays an important role. First thing is you can do is obviously keep your own name. And if you think that your name is quite confusing and you think that people won't be able to remember your name or anything like that, then you can keep something else. Like I did, my channel is Creations to Inspire, whereas my name is Ayushi Singh. So you can either keep your name or you can keep something else that represent your videos, that represent your channel, your personality. So if you are starting a channel, the best advice that I would give is just start with whatever you have. Yes, because you don't know how long you're going to survive or completely 100% sure about it. I don't know if you guys know this, but I bought my first DSLR after I crossed 20,000 subscribers.
So I started with whatever I had. I have this Canon point and shoot camera, which is like 6 to 7 years old. Later on, I bought a new mobile. So I started filming with my mobile. Nowadays, mobiles have very good quality camera, so you can use that. Or you can even go for HD point and shoot cameras.
Also, one thing that I would like to share is that my two most viewed video, which is a choker video that has over 1 million views, and creative gift ideas video, both of them I have filmed it with my cell phone. So no, you don't need a DSLR. Now if you have a budget and you want a DSLR, so there are a lot of options in Canon, Nikon, Sony, and that the one that I use is Canon 700D and it's kit lens.
So first tripod that I bought was this one and I got it for my point and shoot camera. It is very light, but I don't use this for my DSLR. Later on, when I started filming with my mobile, I got this mobile tripod holder so that I can attach it to my tripod and then use it. I'll link the tripod and the mobile tripod holder in the description box. It's very cheap and you can buy both of them under 1,000 rupees. So yes, you can start a YouTube channel with just 1,000 rupees, excluding your cell phone obviously. So for my DSLR, I use this tripod from Reconnect, which I got for free along with my DSLR. You can even go for Fortron tripods or Benro tripod. I'll link both of them in the description box.
Next are lights. So I use natural light. I have a window over here, so I just use natural light. I don't have soft boxes or artificial light, so I have to work according to the climate and according to the light. So I prefer filming from morning 11 o'clock to 1 or 2:30ish, and from 4:30 to 6 o'clock sometimes, or till 5:30, because that is the time when I get normal light. Otherwise, the light is very harsh and very warm and you don't want to look that bad in video. So this is the timing when I like to film videos. And if you are looking for softbox or for artificial lights, I'll link some of them in the description box. You can go and check that out.
Editing software that I use is Sony Vegas Pro 13. You can even go for 11. So for Windows users, I would suggest to go for Sony Vegas Pro, PowerDirector 12, Adobe, Wondershare, and for Mac users, iMovie and Final Cut Pro.
Now how to use software and how to edit everything you can find on YouTube. YouTube is a great place to search all your questions. I'm not saying that you'll learn everything in a day. It will take time, but you can just go on YouTube and watch tutorials. There are tons of tutorials on how to edit videos. Content and ideas are so important. It's not about what lights you use, it's not about your DSLR, fancy editing, everything is secondary. Content is very important.
So I like to write all the ideas in a diary and plan everything before I start filming. This was my ideas book and I used to write, it's a DIY book, I have a video on this. But recently I got a new diary and I'm loving it.
So for my DIYs, I like to use chart papers. So you can go for plain chart papers or you can go for floral or printed chart papers. I like using white, blue and pink color. Now for talking videos and for beauty related videos, you really need to work on the backdrop. So you can go and buy backdrop or you can just add some lights like this. You can add some garlands or flowers. Go and see some of my videos. There's a printed background behind. Actually, that's a dupatta and a lot of people thought that it's a wallpaper. So you can use anything that you have and you think that it will look nice on camera and can be used as a background.
Musics are very important. Plus, it is very important to use a copyright-free music. Yes, when I started, I didn't know what's copyright, so I just used any music and I got a copyright claim on my very first video. So please use copyright-free music. Don't just put any music that you love because you won't be able to monetize your video. You might get a copyright strike or a copyright claim, so don't use. Now, YouTube has saved us and they have an audio library where you can find all copyright-free musics or musics that you can use by just giving credit. So check out YouTube Audio Library for all the copyright-free musics. Thumbnail is so important. Even if your video is nice, nobody will click on your video if you have some dull or blurry thumbnail. I edit my thumbnail on picmonkey.com. Try to make your thumbnail look attractive so that people feel like clicking on your video. Same goes to banner, and even banner I edit on picmonkey.com. I'll link a few tutorials on how to edit banner and thumbnail in the description box.
So once you're done filming, editing and uploading your video, you need to share your videos on all the social media platforms. So you can share it on Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, Facebook. Now collaboration. So once you're very confident about your channel, your videos, you can go and collaborate with other creators. And important thing that I have seen so many people who have just started their channel, subscribe for subscribe. No, if you are serious about YouTube and you're passionate about YouTube, please never ask someone to just subscribe for subscribe. Ask them to check out your channel, but never ask them for subscribe because it shows that you're not serious about your YouTube or you have just started your channel to gain subscribers. So never do sub for sub, but you can ask people to check out your channel, check out your videos. And never hesitate to ask someone to collaborate if you're very confident about your videos or your channel. And final thing, start YouTube channel only if you are passionate about it and you're 100% sure that you want to be a creator or you want to be a YouTuber. Because making videos, it is not an easy job. A lot of people think that you just film video, edit and you upload, that's it. No, it's not an easy job. For me, it takes an entire week if I'm doing a DIY video, filming, taking different shots, intro, outro, everything. So it involves a lot of time. It involves a lot of efforts. So if you're 100% sure about this, then only start. And if you start, continue with it because I won't guarantee that you'll get 1,000 subscribers in a month. Sometimes it takes a year, like me. It took me an year to cross 1,000 subscribers. Sometimes it happens in a day or in a week. So it totally depends. It is unpredictable. No one knows what is going to happen. But you need to continue it if you love it. So all the best and let me know if you start a YouTube channel. And if you do, leave your channel's link in the comment box. I would love to go and watch your videos. So leave them, and yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope this video was helpful. Please make sure to subscribe my channel by clicking that subscribe button and give this video a big thumbs up. Also make sure to click that bell button so that you guys will get notified whenever I upload a new video. Bye bye, keep inspiring.